ओके गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स. ఈ రోజు స్టూడెంట్స్ సెమినార్స్ లో భాగంగా ఈ రోజు చెప్పేటువంటి సెమినార్ టాపిక్ C4 పాత్వే ప్రెజెంటెడ్ బై గాయత్రి విపర్తి. ఓకే సో ఓకే ఓవర్ టు గాయత్రి.
గుడ్ మార్నింగ్ సార్. గుడ్ మార్నింగ్ మై డియర్ ఫ్రెండ్స్. టుడే ఐ వాంట్ టు డిస్కస్ అబౌట్ C4 పాత్వే. C4 ఆర్ C4 సైకిల్. ఇన్ సమ్ ప్లాంట్ స్పీషియస్ ఆల్టర్నేట్ మోడ్స్ ఆఫ్ కార్బన్ ఫిక్సేషన్ have evolved that minimize photorespiration and optimize the Calvin cycle. The C4 cycle was discovered by Hatch and Slack in 1966. So this cycle was named after the discoverance as Hatch and Slack cycle. It is also called as beta carboxylation pathway and cooperative photosynthesis. The first stable compound of Hatch and Slack cycle is 4-carbon oxaloacetic acid. Therefore, it is called C4 cycle. And some examples of these C4 cycles plants are like sugarcane, corn, etc. Leaf anatomy of C4 plants, and it is also called as Cram's anatomy, and it was very interesting. The leaves of C4 plants are unique in possessing two types of photosynthetic cells. The vascular elements in C4 leaves remain surrounded by a layer of bundle sheath cells containing chloroplast in abundance. The bundle sheath is surrounded by one or three layers of mesophyll cells. In transverse sections viewed, the wreath-like manner, two-layer arrangement of the chloroplast-bearing cells surrounding the vascular bundle is termed as Cram's anatomy. Cram's is the German word, which word for wreath. PEP carboxylase is present in the mesophyll cells, whereas Rubisco is located to the bundle sheath cells. Mesophyll cells contain chloroplasts with stacked thylakoids, while chloroplasts is bundle sheath cells are comparatively quite large in size, exhibit unistacked thylakoids. And now see the cycle of C4 cycle. The basic C4 cycle consists of 4 stages. Discuss about the stages. Fixation of CO2 by the carboxylation of phosphoenolpyruvate in mesophyll cells to form C4 acid. Transport of the C4 acids to the bundle sheath cells. Decarboxylation of the C4 acids within the bundle sheath cells and generation of CO2, which is the reduced to carbohydrate via the Calvin cycle. Transport of the C4 acid that is formed by the decarboxylation step by back to mesophyll cell and regeneration of the CO2 acceptor phosphoenolpyruvate. Reactions of C4 cycle or Hatch and Slack cycle. C4 cycle is completed in the chloroplast of mesophyll cell and bundle sheath cells. And these following reactions occur during this cycle. Reactions occurring in this chloroplast of mesophyll cell. The first reaction is formation of oxaloacetic acid. The primary acceptor of CO2 in the cycle is 3-carbon compounds, phosphoenolpyruvic acid. In mesophyll cells, the atmospheric CO2 first combined with water to form bicarbonate ion. In the presence of enzyme carbonic anhydrase, the CO2 acceptor phosphoenolpyruvic acid, which stands for PEP. PEP stands for phosphoenolpyruvic acid, combines with CO2 and form a 4-carbon acid, oxaloacetic acid, in the presence of enzyme PEP carboxylase. These steps requires a molecule of water and release a molecule of phosphoric acid. In the first reaction, the enzyme is carbonic anhydrase, and the second reaction, the enzyme is malic dehydrogenase. The oxaloacetic acid can be also be converted into aspartic acid in the presence of enzyme aspartic transaminase. The C4 acids or malic acid and aspartic acid are the transported to the chloroplast of bundle sheath. Reactions occurring in bundle sheath chloroplast. And the third reaction is formation of pyruvic acid. In bundle sheath chloroplast, the malic acid undergoes oxidative decarboxylation to yield pyruvic acid and CO2 in the presence of malic enzyme. The CO2 and NADPH+ produced by oxidative decarboxylation of malic acid enter into Calvin cycle. The CO2 combines with ribulose disophosphate, which is RUDP, to yield 2 molecules of phosphoglyceric acid. In mesophyll cells, formation of phosphoenol pyruvic acid. The pyruvic acid is transported back to the mesophyll cells, where it is phosphorylated into phosphoenol pyruvic acid in the presence of enzyme pyruvate phosphate dichoinase. And dear friends, one last and important thing I want to share with you. That is, C4 plants predominate in open and arid habitats and also include several important food crops such as maize and sugarcane. C4 plants have a competitive advantage over C3 plants at high temperature and under strong light because of a reduction of photorespiration and an increase in absolute rates of CO2 fixation at current ambient CO2. Such increase in photosynthetic efficiency results in faster carbon gain and commonly higher growth rates, particularly in subtropical and tropical environments. Consequently, and in response to the looming food security crisis, a global research effort led by IRRI, International Rice Research Institute, is underway to bioengineer C4 photosynthetic rice into major C3 crops such as rice in order to boost their photosynthesis and thus improve yield and resource use efficiency. Thank you to all.
వెరీ గుడ్ గాయత్రి, థ్యాంక్ యూ, బాగా చెప్పారు C4 పాత్ర గురించి. నెక్స్ట్ సుప్రియ, షేర్ స్క్రీన్.
ఓకే సార్. గుడ్ మార్నింగ్ సార్. Today my topic is photosynthesis light and dark reactions. The light reaction of photosynthesis involves light driven electron and proton transfers which
screen,
occur in
screen
the
zoom cheyamma screen adanga cheppanu adanga screen portrait lo pettan landscape lo very good baa kanapadutundi.
Light driven electron and proton transfers which occurs in the thylakoid membrane, whereas the dark reaction involves the fixation of CO2 into carbohydrate via the Kelvin-Benson cycle which occurs in the stroma. Plants and some single-celled organisms use photosynthesis to transform water and carbon dioxide into glucose. Light is essential to this energy generating process. When darkness falls, photosynthesis stops. Photosynthesis, a process by which green plants and certain other organisms transform light into chemical energy. Photosynthesis consists of a number of photochemical and enzymatic reactions. It occurs in two stages. During the light dependent stage, which chlorophyll absorbs light energy, which excites some electrons in the pigment molecules to higher energy levels. These leave the chlorophyll and pass along a series of molecules, generating formation of NADPH, an enzyme, and high energy ATP molecules. NADPH and ATP drive the second stage, the dark reaction, or Kelvin cycle discovered by Melvin Kelvin, which does not require light. During this stage, glucose is generated using atmospheric carbon dioxide. Photosynthesis is crucial for maintaining life on Earth. If it ceased, there would soon be little food or other organic matter on the planet, and most types of organisms would disappear. Photosynthesis comprises two phases. The first phase is photochemical phase or light dependent process. This phase is commonly known as light reaction. The second phase is the biosynthetic phase of the dark reaction of photosynthesis. This phase is the light independent process. As stated above, photosynthesis occurs in the two phases, light and dark reaction. The light reaction as light dependent process, which includes a series of events such as light absorption, hydrolysis, the release of oxygen, formation of ATP and NADPH. The light reaction of photosynthesis initiates only when it is supplied with light energy. The light reaction occurs in the thylakoids of chloroplasts. The dark reaction is also called carbon fixing reaction. It is a light independent process in which sugar molecules are formed from the carbon dioxide and water molecules. Dark reaction occurs in the stroma of the chloroplast, where they utilize the products of the light reaction. Light reaction photolysis occurs in PS2, and in dark reaction photolysis does not occur. Light reaction takes place in grana of chloroplast, where in the dark reaction takes place in stroma of the chloroplast. Thank you.
ఓకే సుప్రియ బాగా చెప్పారు సీ3 సైకిల్ గురించి. ఇంత చెప్పవలసి ఉంది అండి, క్లాసు సెమినారు సాహితి ఈరోజు చెప్పేశాను మీరు. వెల్కమ్ సాహితి, ఓవర్ టు సాహితి.
ఎస్ సార్.
ఓకే
సార్ షేర్ అవుతుందా సార్?
అవుతుంది అవుతుంది.
గుడ్ మార్నింగ్ టు ఆల్. టుడే మై టాపిక్ ఇస్ సిట్రిక్ యాసిడ్.
ల్యాండ్స్కేప్ లో మీరు కూడా ల్యాండ్స్కేప్ లో పెట్టండి. టర్న్ చేయండి మొబైల్, టర్న్ చేయండి, ఫుల్ స్క్రీన్ వస్తుంది. మొబైల్ ని ఇలా టర్న్ చేయండి అమ్మా, ఆర్జెంటల్ గా పెట్టండి. వెర్టికల్
గుడ్ మార్నింగ్ టు ఆల్. టుడే మై టాపిక్ ఇస్ సిట్రిక్ యాసిడ్ సైకిల్. ఇట్స్ ఆల్సో కాల్డ్ యాజ్ ట్రై కార్బోక్సిలిక్ యాసిడ్ సైకిల్. It was introduced by Hans Krebs. It is also called as Krebs cycle. First of all, you need to know about when pyruvic acid is the cree product of glucose. It depends on cellular need. It completely oxidizes the glucose into CO2 and H2O. This is known as Krebs cycle or citric acid cycle. The main functions of citric acid cycle is harvesting high energy electrons and generate the large amount of ATPs. It's mainly synthesis citrate and gluconeogenesis and degradation of acetyl CoA to produce energy. In citric acid cycle, the acetyl CoA is entered into cyclic pathway. It is also called as tricarboxylic acid cycle. In tricarboxylic acid cycle, starts with a condensation of acetyl group with oxaloacetic acid and water to yield citric acid. The reaction is catalyzed by the enzyme citric. The reaction is catalyzed by the enzyme citric synthase, and the molecule of coenzyme A is released. Citrate then isomerized to isocitrate. The following two successive steps of decarboxylation leading to the formation of alpha ketoglutaric acid and then succinyl coenzyme A. In the remaining steps of citric acid cycle, succinyl coenzyme is oxidized to oxaloacetic acid, allowing the cycle to continue. During the conversion of succinyl coenzyme A to succinic acid, a molecule of GTA is synthesized. This is the substrate level of phosphorylation. In a couple of reactions, GTA is converted into GTP with the stimulation synthesis of ATP from ADP. Also, there are three points in the cycle where NAD plus is reduced to NADH plus plus H ion, and one point where FAD plus is reduced to FADH2. The continued oxidation of acetyl CoA of tricarboxylic acid cycle requires the continued replenishment of oxaloacetic acid, the first member of the cycle. In addition, it also requires regeneration of NADP plus NAD FAD plus from NADH and FADH2 respectively. The citric acid cycle is followed on followed by 10 steps. It's also the steps is known as condensation, dehydration, hydration, oxidation, decarboxylation, oxidative decarboxylation, cleavage, oxidation and hydration. The oxidation is continuous four times in this cycle, and finally completion of the cycle, the glucose has been broken down and released CO2 and 8 molecules of NADH+, 2 of FADH2 has been synthesized besides just 2 molecules of ATP. And the cycle is represented in the equation form like this. These are the steps followed by the cycle, citric acid cycle. The final products of this cycle is a large amount of ATP. First, the mainly purpose of this cycle is energy harvesting cycle is also called as citric acid cycle. Thank you.
Okay, thank you. Thank you. I think so. Repo class ka WhatsApp cheyandi. Maybe I will get the topic. Okay. Thank you very much. Attendance is done.